Very good morning to all the children of class 10th D. Yes, beta, today we are going to do writing skill. Okay, letter of enquiry. Though you have done it earlier in the last term also, but this is there in your second term too. So, isliye we have to do this again. Fine, because there is a gap of so many days in between, you might have forgotten also. Then let's revise it. Fine, letter of enquiry. Now, why this letter of inquiry is written? Firstly, if anybody would like to tell, raise hand, I will unmute you. Why letter of inquiry is written? What is the purpose of this letter? Anybody? Please be active enough while giving responses. Don't be so lazy. Okay. So, letter of inquiry, yes, beta, to seek information. Yes, very good. So, letter of inquiry is written to seek information. Fine. If you have any queries regarding anything, yes, to inquire about the details of something. Yes, Divyansh, right. Fine. So, your writing in the chat box is easier for you. No problem. I will be announcing the name along with the answer given by the students. So, whenever we need to seek any details about anything, any information about anything, fine, then we write letter of inquiry. So this is one of the parts of business letters also. Fine, and it can be and letter of inquiry can be written to anyone. Suppose you want to inquire about the quotation. Quotation is a price list. Okay, you would like to ask about the quotation of some books from any dealer, from any shopkeeper. Then you can write a letter of inquiry. Suppose you want to inquire about the you can say data charges of your, you get recharge every month. You want to ask about that, fine. About your recharge of your, you can say channels on the television, about anything it can be. Don't restrict yourself to only books only. You want, you are one of the heads in the institution. It doesn't mean you will always get that you are a student somewhere, okay? You can get that you are manager somewhere and you want to purchase new crockery for your house, or you are manager of some hotel, you want to purchase crockery for your hotel, you want quotation for that, fine. It can be at small scale, it can be at large scale, it can be anything. So any assumed character can be given to you, fine. Do not restrict yourself to be only student, fine. So we will be doing one example, then it will be more clear to you. Now, firstly, please, I'm going to discuss the format with you all. Let me change the view. Is it visible, beta? Last word is designation, right? So let me discuss firstly. Please note down. First of all, this line, actually the margin of your notebook or your paper, fine? So sender's address. From the extreme left side, you will be writing sender's address. It is basically 2 to 3 line address given to you. Fine, and it is basically written in the statement itself. Most of the times it is given. Fine. And if it is not given, you can write any assumed address also. No problem in that. So sender's address is the one who is sending the letter. Your address means you are writing the letter. And suppose it is given to you, you are Ashok Mehta of 32 Model Town, Jalandhar. Fine. So your address will be 32 Model Town in one line, Jalandhar in next line. Fine. Suppose in case some block number is given, some street number is given, 32 Model Town street near this, any landmark is given near Gurdwara Sahib, whatever landmark is given there near Gita Mandir, Model Town, Jalandhar. Fine, whatever address is given in the statement, all those words you will be using in the sender's address. Do not add from your own side. Fine, whatever is given, if it is a 2-line address given in the statement, you use 2-line address. If it is 3 lines address given to you, then you will be writing the address in 3 lines only. Fine. Then after skipping one line, address to be written in consecutive lines means ek mein aapne house number likha, next line mein street number, next line mein city. You need not skip a line over there. But when your sender's address is done, when you have written sender's address, then skip one line, okay? And then write date. And the format of the date will be like this. Do not use the word date over there. D-A-T-E, aap nahi likhoge. Directly, you will be writing the date like this. क्लियर, दिस इज द राइट फॉर्म है, डू नॉट राइट लाइक दिस, ये करेक्ट है, ऐसे नहीं लिखोगे. इन न्यूमेरिक्स इट इज नॉट कंसिडर्ड करेक्ट, फाइन, व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग अ लेटर इन इंग्लिश, इन ऑल न्यूमेरिक्स यू शुड अवॉइड, ओके, राइट लाइक दिस, और यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट जनवरी 10, 2022, अदरवाइज वी डू नॉट पुट कॉमास एट द एंड of the address, date, receiver's address. No commas, no full stops are to be used. Please make sure. Then after writing date, clear beta? After writing date, again, you will skip one line and then receiver's address. Now, very important thing is, in receiver's address, one receiver should be there. Fine, in sender, you have just written the address only, you have not written any name. But in receiver's address, the very first line should be the designation of the person to whom you are sending the letter. Suppose you are writing a letter to the manager of some hotel asking about the catering system. We will be doing one for that only, catering. You want to organize a function at your home, some birthday is there, marriage ceremony of your sibling is there, and you want to inquire about the rates per plate, about decoration charges and all that stuff, fine. So you, to whom you will write, you will not write the director, the principal, no. In a hotel, definitely there will be some manager, a person will be there who is responsible for giving you all the answers to the inquiries. So you will be writing the designation of that person, name nahi likhogi. Find date and then skip one line, you will write the manager. Next, hotel, hotel ka name, fine. Then whatever name of the hotel, Hotel Ramada Encore. Then Jalandhar, clear, in that way. So three line address definitely will be here in receiver's address. Their sender's address depends upon your statement. Very good, today almost all the students are joining, very good. So, okay, subject is there. Then after that, receiver's address, we have discussed one designation, address. No full stops, no commas. Then skip one line once again. Sender's address, then skip one line, then date, then skip one line, receiver's address, skip one line. Now you will write the subject. Now subject, you will not write like ing words to be avoided here, fine. And infinitive also to be avoided here. What are infinitive and ing words? Let me tell you that. You will not write inquiring about the prizes, inquiring about the sports items. Aise nahi likhoge. Fine. Inquiry. Inquiry about this thing. ing word is to be avoided. Clear? Ing word use karoge to subject galat. To inquire about galat. Infinitive is also not to be used here. Okay. So you will be writing inquiry about dash. Inquiry about dash. Whatever the inquiry is. Clear? Inquiry about quotes of sports item. Inquiry about, fine, a quotes of catering per head, in that way. Whatever your query depends upon the statement given to you. Is that clear? Send me thumbs up quickly. Because these are the silly mistakes which we commit during you can say basic things. If you really want 10 on 10, I'm telling you, you say na that we do not get marks in English, your term 2 is totally subjective, fine. So we are ready to give you marks, but if you follow the format, if any mistake is done, you will ruin it, fine. You won't be able to get marks. Then now this is your wish, whether you would like to leave a line or not. Now, fine, in the very next line you can write, or you can skip a line, that's your choice. Now onwards. So in next line we will be writing dear sir or madam, depending upon the statement, what name is given to you, to whom you are addressing, whose name was there in the receiver's address. So dear sir or madam, both you will not write, clear. Then in the next line that I have written in the content part of the poem, this is called body of the letter, fine. And this is called salutation, where we address the receiver. Dear sir, dear madam. Only this part is called. You should know the parts of the letter. This part is called salutation. This is the heading, fine. this is salutation, this is body of the letter or content, then this is called subscription. Clear? Or complimentary clause also. Isko hum complimentary clause bhi bol dete hai and subscription bhi bol dete hai. Fine, both the words are apt for the ending. Clear this part. Is that clear? Send me thumbs up quickly. I'm just checking those who are, you know, quick responses are coming. I just check the names and I see they are very attentive in the class. Very good. Fine. So I'm checking who is throughout attentive. At last, I will be announcing the names also. Now, the thing is, what to be written in the body of the letter? Bit of heading, Tanya. That is the heading part. Fine. Then, what to write in the first paragraph, what to write in the second, and what to write in the third. Let's discuss that now. Now, in the very first paragraph, introduction. Your introduction, fine. And purpose of writing the letter. In the very first paragraph, you know, when you start writing, you are out of ideas. What should I write now? How to start the letter? Most of the students, they forget that how to write the letter. The reason is we do not pay attention. That how to, you know, write a letter. So always remember, firstly, you need to introduce yourself, fine. And then after giving your introduction, you will tell the purpose of writing. I'm writing this letter to inquire about dash, whatever inquiry you want to make. Clear? So after telling your, suppose you are the manager of some hotel, you are seeking information, or you are a student only, or you can say, working as HR manager, you're working as an accountant, whatever designation and name can be given to you, you have to stick to that only throughout the letter. Imagine yourself to be that person only. Clear? So after giving introduction of yourself, after telling the purpose of writing the letter, then you will switch to second paragraph. Okay. So first paragraph will carry only 2 to 3 lines. 2 to 3 lines, that's okay. Now, second paragraph is the main paragraph in which the whole content of or the body of the letter, the main content where you will make inquiries, okay, where you will ask questions or seek information to the person, okay. Now, how to seek information? You know, some children, they keep on writing, I want to ask that. Do not use, please, repeated phrases. That makes your letter very dull. You should have various different ways of seeking information also. Fine. And dekho, main letter is letter of inquiry. It doesn't mean you will make one inquiry and that's over. You have to ask, you have to seek information, basically 3 to 5 inquiries, minimum 3, maximum 5. It doesn't mean 10 inquiries. Don't go above the board, okay? 10 inquiries bhi nahi karni hai and 1-2 bhi nahi karni hai. So you have to minimum 3, maximum 5. 5 is the, I guess, the best option for you. 4 should be there. 3 is less, 5 is perfect. Fine, 4 to 5 inquiries you are supposed to make in that second paragraph. But you will not use the same words. Fine. You will use some phrases. Let me tell you what phrases you can use here. I have told you earlier also, if anybody remembers, I will really appreciate that child. Really, I will appreciate. Please raise your hands. Come on. How to ask for the information, how to seek details. Jaldi se. Who's the intelligent one? Let me see. Out of these 40 students present today, which is a good number. Yes, Tanya, let me know. Yes, Harsimran, let me know about this. Yes, Tanya, again, I would like to inquire about. Very good, very good. Yes. So quick responses. In typing, you are too fast rather than unmuting. Okay, whatever option you are having, I appreciate you answered. So Bissam, Tanya, Harsimran, they have answered this question. Clear? Well done to all these three children. So there are n number of ways of seeking information. I want to know. I would like to ask. I would like to inquire about dash, whatever inquiry is there. Fine. Let me know about the details of dash. Fine. Please note down these phrases, beta. These are the ones who are helping you here. The whole thing I'm telling you, the only additions you need to ask, you need to add is about will depend upon the statement given to you. Kindly tell me about dash. See, for three inquiries, I already wrote some phrases. I would like to inquire about, let me know about the details of dash. Fine. Kindly tell me about, yes, Raina, very good. If you could tell me about this, I wonder if you could tell me, rather than using the word wonder, Raina, you use the word appreciate. Okay. I would appreciate if you would let me know about. Clear? I would appreciate if you would let me know about dash. Fine, well done, Raina also. Yes, if you could tell me, sorry, I would appreciate if you could tell me. Because let me know wala same ho jayega hamara. If you will tell me, if you could tell me. About dash. So please note down these four group of words or phrases. I would appreciate if you could tell me about dash. I would like to inquire about dash. Let me know about the details of dash too. Kindly tell me about dash. Clear? In the second paragraph, you will be using these phrases and you will make inquiries, not inquiry. Letter of inquiry name hai, but you are supposed to ask 3 to 4 inquiries. Seek information. Even you can write, please give me the information about that too. Ye bhi add kar lo. Please give me the, you can request them also. Please give me the information about dash 2. Clear? So this is your second paragraph in which you will make inquiries. Kindly bring it to my kind notice. Yes, Bissam, well done. Kindly bring it to my kind notice. So see, there are n number of ways of seeking information, but do not write, I want to ask, I want to ask. Those who do not listen to the teacher, they have that problem. Those who are attentive listeners, they will definitely follow these things and nobody will stop you in gaining marks. You will definitely get good marks if you follow these set of instructions. Okay, second paragraph is seek information. Fine, make inquiries. So in letter of inquiry, if inquiry is not made, then what has you to do over there? Fine. Inquiry ki letter mein inquiries hi hoengi. Now in third paragraph, what to write in third paragraph? Anybody can tell me? Come on. In third paragraph, what to do? Yes, Vivan is saying suggestions. Beta, suggestions usme hoti hai. when problem is discussed in letter to editor, in any problem when we are forwarding to anyone. So Vivan, sorry to say, but suggestions nahi. Yes, Tanya, request to dispatch the information and gave answer to the letter. Very good. Well done. Fine. In the last paragraph, Vivan, I appreciate you for participating. Well done. Fine. But in this letter of inquiry, no suggestions, only you ask for them to reply to your letter. Fine. Request them to give reply as soon as possible. Clear? So in the last paragraph, you will request them to give reply or send you the reply as soon as possible. At last, then after when you are done, in third paragraph also, it will be 2 to 3 lines only, in which you can tell that, because suppose you are going to conduct, your sister is getting married, you're writing that, your brother is getting married, or any birthday is there, you're writing that, because the birthday falls on this date. So it is compulsory to send us information by this date or within 2 weeks or by 5th of Feb, fine, in that way. So I request you to dispatch the information as soon as possible. You can ask for the menu card, or please send us the email, or please send us the quotation of the prices of sports goods. Whatever inquiry you have made in regard to that, you have to add 2-3 lines. You need to request them to give you reply as soon as possible, along with, you know, brochure is given these days. Brochure is a booklet in which the detailed information is given. Clear? And it is there in the case of some function you are organizing or some admission. Suppose you want to take admission into some college. Fine. In that case, brochures are there. You want to participate in an event in which a list of events is given, in that case, but not in all the cases brochure is there. Okay. In the case of a restaurant and hotel, you want to ask about the price list or quotation, then menu card, you can ask the information for. Please also dispatch menu card along with your reply. We will really appreciate you. Yes, Vic will appreciate later. Who helped me? No, beta. No, Raina, you are reading from somewhere, I guess. You will not use the word victim will appreciate and all. No, these words are not at all allowed in letter of inquiry. Only you will write that we will appreciate your efforts if you send us reply so that we can take timely decision. I know, Raina, but we avoid the word victim in this letter of inquiry, okay? So don't write that word, I know. So you will be writing that so that timely decision can be taken. Ilan likhlo ek bar. Then please send us reply by 15th of Jan 2022 so that timely decision can be taken in regard to this. If timely decision kis case mein hoga, in which you need to place an order, if you need to give some booking, fine, in that case. If you want to seek admission, in that case. Agar waisi aapne koi inquiry ki hai regarding anything, then there is no need. Then at last, subscription or complimentary close mein kya aega? Skip one line. After when your body of letter is done, then skip one line, write yours truly. And please write the correct spelling. You always write T-R-U-E-L-Y. Vahan se bhi aapke toppers ke bhi marks vahan se jate hain. You know that? T-R-U-E likh dete ho. E is not there. When you write truly word, E goes away. Okay? When we add adverb, L-Y jab add karte hain, toh E omit ho jate hain. This is a rule. So yours truly, name, not your name, but the name which is given to you. Fine? That name, that identity which is given to you in the statement. Suppose your name is Mohita, then you will be writing that name only. Clear? And then designation. Designation means post. It is optional, beta, to write designation. If it is given in the statement that you are head boy of the school, you want to purchase some sports items, then, or you're the sports secretary of the school, then you want to purchase sports items, then aapka designation sports secretary ho jayega. You are the head boy, designation head boy. No designation is given, then leave it. There is no compulsion that you have to invent it. If it is given in the statement, then you will write the designation. If it is not given in the statement, you can omit it. Yes. Tell me any doubt. Clear? Harsimran is saying, yes, ma'am, it's clear. That thumbs up speaks in itself. Now, please note down the statement. Yes, Divyansh, Mehak. Very good. Those who are still attentive enough. Bissam is there. Sayam is there. I know that half of the class to bahut attentive hai. Half of the class just passing the time. Lakshya is there. Isha, Preet, Pratham, Nandini, Hasita, Aryan, Dishant, Vanita. Yes, Divyansh, in third paragraph, you just need to, because you cannot overwrite the letter, you cannot write two pages. Yes, definitely, Bhanu, definitely, beta. Now, is it visible to you? By the time students are noting down, I'm going to speak the statement. You can note down, beta, please note down from the board. I have kept myself on the side only so that you can note down. So please note down this statement that you will do in your fair notebook, beta. Yes, Divyansh, you can write favorable response in third paragraph. I am giving you the liberty to do the additions, but do not do the deletion. Isme se kuch delete mat karna because these are the basic necessities. Additions, your choice. Okay, letter of inquiry, statement likhiye beta. Write a letter seeking detailed inquiries. Write a board is there, okay? You can note down later on also. Pehle aap statement likh lo, which I'm speaking for you all. Write a letter seeking detailed inquiries from the general manager. Write a letter seeking detailed inquiries from the general manager. G capital, M capital. General manager, comma, Holiday Inn. Ye hotel ka name hai. Holiday Inn. INN. Okay. Holiday Inn. General manager, comma, Holiday Inn, comma, Kanpur. Kanpur. K-A-N-P-U-R. For conducting the wedding reception of, for conducting the wedding reception of your brother at the hotel. Your brother at the hotel. For conducting the wedding reception of your younger brother at the hotel. Full stop. Make specific inquiries about the, now but a very important thing, you have to be smart enough. Do teen inquiries aapki sara kuch aapko bata diye. Now what to write in these dash, ye bhi aapki statement mein given hote hain, and two things are given, two three you have to add up, fine. So please note down, make inquiries, make specific inquiries about the catering cost per head, about the catering cost per head. Please note down spelling. Catering. C-A-T-E-R-I-N-G. Catering cost per head, comma, service and decoration charges, full stop. Service and decoration charges, full stop. You can also ask for the advance amount to be paid. Sari inquiry statement mein bata diye, but you have to be smart enough to write it. You can also ask for the advance amount to be paid. Full stop. You are Krishna or Kamini. You are Krishna or Kamini of NA 167, NA 167, Modern Colony, Kanpur. Modern Colony, Kanpur. Have a nice day and please do this letter in your fair notebook. I will ask you to read it later. Okay? Have a nice day.